Treyarch has a lot of work to do. That's all I can say on Cold War. That's no, but we are going to be talking about the unpolished child known as Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War, or just Cold War. I mean, you could even call it the Black Ops 4 remake from 1983 if you really want to, because we're going to start off by saying the running or the walking in the game, the characters don't feel like they have weight. They feel like they just came straight out of Black Ops 3, Black Ops 4, and they removed all the jetpacks. They're like, well, you know, the realism that we've been stimulated to for the past year about, you know, Warzone and Call of Duty Modern Warfare's multiplayer is just kind of uplifted, and now we have, like, these very lightweight characters that we are using. So that is, like, the first thing that strikes the very core of any Call of Duty player from either franchise, whoever you're a fan of, whether you are an Infinity War fan or a Treyarch fan, you are going to notice that this is a lot like Black Ops 4, and it does not have the oomph that Modern Warfare has, or Black Ops 2 had, or the old Call of Duties, or even Black Ops 3. Black Ops 3, obviously, you know, it was jetpacks, but at least the characters had a step. You don't feel that in this game. I'm not saying to not buy the game, because it is still very appealing and very fun to play. It is definitely a Black Ops. You can just tell that right off rip. That is definitely something that I would want to point out to anyone who is coming here thinking that Warzone is going to be the same. The characters do not have an oomph. There is going to be a struggle between, you know, how much weight your character will have. The next thing I kind of want to bring up is going to be actually the score streaks slash kill streaks, because when the beta comes out and everyone sees this, the amount of complaints are going to be so high that I think Treyarch might have to end up changing it back to what we're used to, kind of like how Infinity Ward had to do last year with there being no mini map in the multiplayer, and then they ended up just turning it on for the core game modes. It's going to be something similar to that, and if they don't, people are going to be pissed, because the new system of kill streaks is very difficult to learn at first, because you need to work on time of getting multiple kill streaks rather than getting kill and die in order to actually get something like the chopper gunner. Otherwise, you will only have the spy plane in RCXD most of the time, because there are 90 second cooldowns and the time it's a time-based kill streak. You have to get like a multiplier off of how many kills you get instead of just getting 12 kills and then getting the thing you want. You have to get 12 kills and still wait out the time so that your score will rack up high enough to where you can actually get the kill streaks. Now, I want to talk about some of the kill streaks right now, starting off with the chopper gunner. Chopper gunner, you need like 6,000 score, and it takes like 10 rockets or so to knock it out of the sky. The RCXD in this one is a lot slower than it was in Black Ops 4, and it's actually a lot slower than it was in Black Ops 2 as well. It's a little bit slower than the one in Black Ops 1, but not by too much. It's a very slow RCXD. It's kind of upsetting to see. Even the boost doesn't really help, because now it makes it easier for people to shoot it and destroy it, and it's kind of pointless if it has a 90-second cooldown. I feel like the 90-second cooldown for the RCXD should only be like 30 seconds or 25 seconds, but that's just my personal opinion on how everything goes. Obviously, they need to just fix the kill streaks back to what they used to be, where you go from 0 to, like, for instance, 19 kills in order to get, like, a chopper gunner or attack dogs. The grenades in the game, they are thrown very slow. They have like a second time that will actually end up getting you killed, because you have to pull the pin. If it could just toss it out, I'm pretty sure you would not be in harm's way, because if you need to throw a grenade into a precise area, you have a chance of missing it, or you have a chance of it not landing where you want it to because someone shot you and your character flinched. Now, the thing I say for last is actually some of the graphics. I understand Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War is in alpha stage right now, but I kind of wanted to point this out. Currently, when you walk through the snow, you actually don't see any footprints. And when you drive through the snow on the snowmobiles or the tanks, it also doesn't leave tread tracks, which is kind of weird, because in Black Ops 1, 2, 3, and 4, when you walk through snow, you actually would see your boot prints, or at least the boot prints in the snow. I just wanted to point that out to see if they actually fix that when the game comes out as a beta in October and the actual full game comes out in November. We'll see all that when it actually happens. But as of right now, in the alpha stage of Call of Duty Cold War, they do not have it to where when you walk through the snow, your tread is on the snow, which is kind of upsetting. I don't want to see them cut back on something like that. But I mean, if they have to wait for when, you know, it comes out on PS5, Xbox Series X, you know, that kind of stuff, that makes a lot more sense. But right now, as as of the alpha, like I said, there is no treads tracks in the snow. If you guys did enjoy today's video, please leave a like on it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. It does help me out a lot. Also, follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Twitch, at Fatal Shoddy. I post over there about every so often. I will catch you guys again soon. This has been Fatal Shoddy with Call of Duty Cold War. I'll catch you guys again soon in the next video. Peace.